Glenn pours the quality stuff in here.
So are there two rooms?
Yeah, there's actually two rooms.
Yes.
Come on, let's go ahead.
This one?
Howdy.
Hey.
Welcome.
How are you?
Hi.
Oh, nice. It's a tannoy.
Yeah.
But the bat preamp in front end and the amp.
This is the Rex 3 preamp and Rex 3 power amp.
Mm. Take the money.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Honey, love is blind.
I love it.
Like the furniture.
Love is blind.
Sit down, Nathaniel.
Yeah, please. So Kabbalah Sasana, Playback Designs, back in the streamer.
Their best, that's their dream system.
Yes.
And the Rex preamp, 2 chassis. And the,
There will be a Rex film stage coming out. That's the current.
Okay. And the Technics SL-1000.
Yeah, that's cool.
With a Hanna cartridge.
A Hanna?
Yeah, that's the
old one. Direct drive
techniques? Yeah. Yeah, that's all they do. Yeah.
Well, you know the story of this development with Technics?
No.
I'll do it the old-fashioned way.
Oh, you gonna bend over?
Yeah.
No future in that.
They decided to get back in the game about 5-6 years ago. And so they basically brought back the classic SL-1200 look. But the whole thing was redesigned. It was redesigned around a brushless slotless direct drive motor that has no cogging, and it has incredible torque. Now this is the SL-1200, which sells for $4,000. It 5 years ago, 4 years ago, it doesn't. It still does. This, however, is the super turntable from them, and these are so hard to get. I waited 9 months to get 3 of these. This has got. It's the quietest turntable in the world, the least speed deviation in the world, and it doesn't sound like a direct drive turntable because there's no cocking.
And they put more into the plant than everything?
Oh, yeah.
Right.
This is a 100-pound turntable.
Really?
Which, by the way, I'm not sure.
Yeah, the size of the motor drive is so heavy, too.
It's unbelievable.
Is that right?
And look at the layer of brass. How thick that is, or how heavy it is. You know, I screwed up. I didn't bring my kit. I have one of only 2 kits in North America. And I did. You know, well, the story behind the motor. I've got the raw motor.
Okay. And how much did that sell for?
That's $19,000.
Okay.
And by the way, I'm the first to admit, you can't precisely do azimuth alignment with this head shell like I can with other head shells.
Uh-huh.
But it's close enough that it sounds great. And the thing is, it looks so cool. Now, in my world, I like to have things that look nice.
Right.
And it looks, this is an Ortofone with Arishi lacquer. And of course, that's what they're doing with that Umami cartridge.
Okay. Now the tannoys, how much do these go for?
$18,000.
Okay. These are the 10-inch, there's a 12-inch above them. I don't know what it's called.
The GRF.
GRF.
Which is the more modern, albeit still beautiful wood. And that we have down in one of our showrooms in Champaign. But I've always been intrigued by this one because it's perfect for me, Lee.
It's an expensive armrest, but well, it's beautiful.
It's really it's bespoke. It's custom made.
Yeah,
that's right. It's a
it's dual purpose, you know.
Right. It's now you put the spikes on.
Oh, that's true.
I mean, the spikes in rooms like these are the least of my worries. Anyway, I'm sorry to get in the way.
Well, maybe you could tell me though, with Tannoy, with their grounding, they're one of the few that does a grounding post on the back.
Right.
What is their thoughts behind why?
You know, I don't really know. I don't know the technical details on that. I'm a speaker guy. Okay. I was one of the co-founders of the company called Dunleavy Audio Labs.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah. And of course, that was not part of our technology at all. But I don't care about so many things. All I want to do is know what does it sound like.
Why? Yeah. Why work? Why stress?
As a Dunleavy guy. You know, the fact that this has a true point source, and it's so open, it's...
It looks beautiful, too.
Yeah, women like it, and that's a big option.
Better than the Dunleavy coffins.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I freely admit this, the weakness of our company is we could never get the cabinets right. The veneerings were not, you know, we just fought
catalog.
I left that company in 95.
Okay.
In the spring of 95. And co-founded Balanced Audio Technologies. So that's what I had from 95 until.
And y'all been in business for a long time.
Well, we sold the company in 2012 to
a
businessman in Chicago. And I stayed on until 2017, but both of my partners, Steve and Victor, are still
With them. Okay. I remember seeing him at shows.
But you know, it's funny. People say, well, why do you still sell Balanced Audio Technology? Well, because I can't find anything that sounds better.
That guy. Yeah.
Start over.